Welcome to the wonderful world of age gap love. Couples decades apart, but happy ever after.
We met online. The initial attraction is obviously physical.
I felt I'd struck gold. Sam was such a lovely guy.
Thank God for the internet.
The uncomfortable truth of being married to a pensioner.
I'm in my latter years.
Oh, don't be saying stuff like that.
The couple who feel banished from their hometown because of their age gap.
They made me feel like I was some sort of animal because I'm going out with a younger girl. I'm going out with a younger girl because this girl has asked me to go out with her.
And the sexy 82-year-old whose new 39-year-old boyfriend is simply not young enough.
A young man is fired up about what the future holds.
I think I'm actually too old for her.
This is the Sunshine State of Florida in America, and a place where age gap love might just blossom.
Hey, you. How are you? Come on in.
Self-confessed cougar Hattie is 82 years old. She has just flown in from New York to stay with her new love interest, 39-year-old John, who happens to adore much older women.
We were connected on social media for years. And we hadn't met, but I was charmed with this woman that I had seen. She told me I could call her, so I called her and we spoke for about an hour or so. And we had discussed, you know, a lot about who I was, who she was, and,
yeah, and
you know,
why we had anything at all in common. So that, of course, he might have wanted to meet me. But he is a man who said that he dates older women.
You feel relaxed?
Yeah, of course.
Despite the 43-year age gap, John couldn't wait to make his way to New York to meet 82-year-old Hattie, and neither could have imagined what happened next.
From the first look I had of him, actually, it was as if I sensed something right away. It's kind of a softness and a warmth. Come on, let me see that face. It's so sweet. He's really sweet. He just spoke to me as if I were like the most astonishing, extraordinary, beautiful, fascinating woman in the world. Or at least I was in that category.
You are. You are one of the most fascinating women that I've met. Like, that hasn't changed.
How could I not like him? He's continuing being really lovely to me.
The attraction this couple felt was irresistible. So 5 weeks on, and Hattie has come for a weekend break to Florida for the first real test of their 43-year age gap relationship.
Over the next couple of days, we're going to go out to a friend of mine's restaurant on the beach so we can go eat there.
This looks like something you would go to. Mad Beach? No.
No, that's more your style. I mean, it's got mad in the title. Come on. I don't think either of us really know what happens after this visit, but she's here, and we're going to have a great time, and she'll meet some people close to me and my friends, and it'll be good.
Age gap love can blossom at any time and at any age. 82-year-old Hattie is spending a few days with a new potential boyfriend, 39-year-old John. John has never dated girls his own age, as he feels he has a lot to offer older women.
I've been asked, and playfully ridiculed, I guess, by people who've known me for a long time, you know, why do I date older women? I like confidence in a woman. I like self-awareness. But I do think with the mature women that I've dated, there's always been a more sensual, more compassionate side. You know, they're very receptive to the type of person and lover that I am.
You know, when I'm here, that reminds me of the Caribbean because of the palm trees.
Do you know what kind of plant that is?
Do you?
Well, it's not a plant, it's an alligator.
Oh, come on.
When Hattie divorced at 48, she made it her mission to only date younger guys, often much younger than John, and she can't get enough.
When people ask me why I like younger men, they always figure it's a hard cock or something. I'm not saying it's not that. However, an older man, generally, he's had this, he once played rugby, he was once the top football player, blah, 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 and he had all these dreams. And I love those dreams. But he had them already. But a young man is fired up about what the future holds. And I can light that light, and I could keep that fire burning.
But the problem is, John is nearly 40, so is his fire already dying out?
I think I'm actually too old for her. That's what we're finding out. It's not about age with me. It's about how a connection between two people can transcend any amount of time between them. But she is hung up on the fact that I'm above 30.
It's morning, and 82-year-old Hattie is also obsessed with keeping in shape.
My medicine ball has been my closest companion for, about 35 years.
Hattie's strict fitness routine is focused on her desire for younger men.
It prepares my body for impact. It's good for sex also, because your body can take a lot of whatever.
39-year-old John, however, is not that into keeping fit.
John's life commitment doesn't have to do with fitness. Also, he's 39, so the issue of aging and anti-aging hasn't really come into the picture yet.
Hattie is on a romantic trip to Florida to see if John is the man for her. But it seems, with him nearing 40 and clearly not into the same things she is, he may not be the young man of her dreams after all.
Being a dancer, I'm going to have physical responses to someone right away. That doesn't mean judgment, because if it were a question of judgment, I would not have been magnetized to this man. However, as I looked out that glass
window... Can we start over without you, like, pointing to my stomach when you say that?
Tensions between Hattie and John worsen, and although she's only been here for a couple of days, John is already finding her a bit too intense.
She's relentless with it, so if she wanted to come down to Tampa to see me, I mean, I thought about her on the drive home from New Jersey, and I thought, you know, come down to visit, but it's still kind of
fresh and new. This I don't like. Okay. No. This has me being, grabbing a guy because I need something from him. No, that's not how it happened.
Well, whatever you were relentless about, you were pretty relentless.
About?
Use your words, then.
No, but what was I?
I wasn't going to interrupt you at all, and I was going to let you finish your statements and say them. So, and I was hoping for the same. And I had you put your hand up when I was talking and interrupt. Even though I didn't agree with a couple of things you said prior, I didn't interrupt and I just let it go. But I won't.
Well, you see, we're very different. That's what we learned.
It's not going very well.
John's booked a table for Hattie's final night in town. It's their last chance to turn things around. Things haven't gone well for 82-year-old Hattie and 39-year-old John, who have one last night out before she heads home to New York.
So we're about to go to my friend Brian's place. That's actually the name of the restaurant. It's called Brian's Place. It's in Hernando Beach, a little bit north of us.
Their final date is a chance for Hattie to pull out all the stops.
Purple lipstick and to balance, put it on my eyebrows. I think it looks great.
After a romantic encounter back home in New York, Hattie came to Florida to see if John was the one for her. But the last few days have not gone well. Let's hope they can turn things around tonight. But despite best efforts, it's ended up being a case of mind the gap.
You talk about age gap. There's distance gap. There's size gap. There's
communication gap.
Communication gap.
There's definitely communication gap.
There are plenty of gaps.
So you get it.
Now, I still feel very loving towards John.
I didn't want you to approach with your mouth open.
My mouth wasn't open.
It was. Anyways, my bad. I was trying to... Yeah, my bad.
No, I kept my tongue in.
But your mouth was open, like...
Hattie returned to New York the next day, and the couple have not been in contact since.